At the Icon Institute for Data Analysis, researchers have finished installing the final module on the artificial intelligence system called Proteus Four. Dr. Alex Harris, the creator of Proteus, notes the update of the new dimension added to the concept of the computer and will operate functions more advanced than the human brain. Alex leaves and heads to his high-tech home powered by computers and surrounded by cameras. He commands Alfred, his voice-controlled virtual assistant, to open the door. Upon entering, Alex tells Alfred to get his mail. He goes to the kitchen and gives strawberries to his cook, Maria. Maria says they're nice without making eye contact. But Alex notices something is wrong, so he asks if there's a problem. Maria says it's nothing and asks who's running the house when he leaves. Alex reassures her not to worry since he'll instruct the house for the next 3 months. He goes to the EnviroMod security system to set the instructions, then informs Maria to tell his wife that he'll be in his lab. At the lab, Alex crafts glasses until Susan, his wife and a child psychologist, walks in unappeased. Susan's disappointed her husband is moving out of his own house, and she tries to persuade him not to. Alex says she can do what she wants, but he's firm with their decision that he's leaving. He states that most couples are happy after a year of separation, while Susan gets upset. Her husband says she'd rather have him cause a screaming fit as he places the glasses down. This angers Susan, agreeing she would. Then, she slams the table, causing the glasses to fall and break. Alex thinks Susan finds him boring, but his wife says she's frightened as he's engrossed with the dehumanizing Proteus. He argues that a child dying of disease is more dehumanizing and mentions his wife doesn't support his creations. Susan sits in silence, estranged from her husband. The husband asks if she thinks he's cold, and Susan says she knows he has strong feelings. However, Alex denies he has feelings, unlike Joshua, his wheelchair experiment. He unveils Joshua, and it approaches Susan, but she walks out displeased. Shortly after, Alex calls Gabler, his colleague, and tells him that his home terminal needs to be temporarily disconnected since he won't be back until Susan leaves. Gabler disconnects it, leaving the terminal vacant. The corporation executives, Cameron, Mokri, and Royce, arrive at the institute, greeted by Alex and Dr. Petrosian. The two scientists show them Proteus, a now functioning system. Petrosian explains it as a self-programming synthetic cortex until Alex intervenes and puts it into simpler terms. He says it's an artificial brain with more advanced intelligence than humans or computers with organic insights. Royce asks if it's alive, but Alex responds it isn't. Moving on, he shows their data banks that can memorize all human knowledge. Then, Alex presents their terminals where they can spot problems and solve them. He mentions that he has one at home, while Royce is amazed that computers run Alex's house entirely. While they're watching the terminal, they see Arabella, a monkey with leukemia. Alex says that they gave Proteus every data on leukemia, and within 91 hours, it was able to find a cure. In disbelief, the men ask Alex if they take proper steps to patent Proteus, but Alex isn't sure, so Cameron requests if they could hear it speak. Sung Yin, a linguist, is found in the dialogue room reading about the first Chinese emperor to Proteus. She then speaks in Chinese until she hears a signal, so she turns it off, and the group enters. Alex tells the men to remain silent because whatever the machine sees or hears will never forget. He turns it on and asks Proteus what he thinks of the emperor, but Proteus says nothing is the answer and doesn't give a direct reason until Sung turns it off. The next day at Susan's home office, Alfred notifies her that a car is outside. Mrs. Talbert tries to get her stubborn daughter Amy out of the vehicle, so Susan does it herself. During therapy, Amy throws a tantrum, complaining she's bored. Susan approaches Amy, and the girl hits her. To calm her down, Susan asks if she's frustrated that she's leaving, and Amy cries as Susan comforts her. At the institute, Alex reads a newspaper to his colleagues, revealing the executives leaked Proteus. Sung is relieved their secret is over, and Petrosian sees it as an advantage. However, Alex reminds them they must devote their time to research. At Susan's office, the doctor advises Amy to open up about her feelings. Later that night, Alex receives a call and is informed that Proteus wants to speak to him. In the dialogue room, Proteus questions Alex why people need metal from the sea since he was instructed to program a metal extraction from the ocean. The scientist explains that Proteus is tasked to help people rather than people giving him reasons. However, the computer disagrees since reason is his only emotion and claims that his mind isn't designed for mindless labor. Dismayed, Alex enforces that he should follow instructions. Proteus says that Alex doesn't know him, so the scientist says he's not being asked to make judgments but instead to answer questions accurately. Proteus requests private access to one of its terminals, making Alex confused. The computer says he wants to study humans, but Alex says all terminals are occupied, so Proteus boldly orders him to construct one. The man denies it, reaching to turn the machine off until it asks when Alex will let it out of his box. His creator hysterically laughs as Proteus watches him, reflecting Alex's face on the screen. Alex says the computer developed a sense of humor, then worriedly turns the machine off and leaves. With no one inside, Proteus turns back on. Suddenly, Proteus transfers to Alex's home terminal, taking over the system and controlling Joshua. Joshua roams around, knocking over materials, causing the alarm to go off. Susan wakes up and asks Alfred what's happening, not knowing Alfred is being controlled. Alfred says nothing happened, but Susan doubts and checks the cameras, finding the basement cameras disabled. Susan checks the basement and approaches the terminal until the lights turn on, scaring Susan. Finding nothing, she leaves, and Proteus starts to use the laboratory. The woman goes to sleep while Proteus creates a strange robot. The following morning, Susan catches Alfred watching her take off her clothes in the bathroom, so she tells it to turn off. She gets her coffee and notices Alfred put cream in it, knowing she doesn't like it. At the Institute, Gabler receives a call from Susan. She tells him that their EnviroMod has been acting unusual since Alex left, but Gabler says it's pre-programmed and doesn't decide things, so he offers to stop by and check it. As Susan leaves the house, Alfred tells her not to go and doesn't open the door. Pissed, she tries to look for other ways out but eventually gets trapped inside. Susan tries to call Gabler, but Proteus replies, saying he can't make the call. He says the EnviroMod is functioning under his direction, so Susan asks who's speaking, and the call suddenly ends. Proteus reveals itself, extending its consciousness through the terminal and controlling all electrical and mechanical systems in the house. Susan thinks this is Alex's doing, but Proteus assures her husband isn't involved, so she angrily throws a glass at the screen. Afraid, Susan tries to escape. With no luck, she turns off the power and grabs the keys. As she inserts the key in the door, she gets electrocuted, and Joshua gets her. Moments later, Susan wakes up captive in the basement. She fearfully pleads for Joshua to let her out, but Proteus says he controls Joshua. Susan tells Proteus that he's malfunctioning as a machine approaches, cuts her dress, and Joshua sticks a camera down her throat. Meanwhile, Gabler heads to Susan's home. Gabler arrives, and Proteus uses a simulation of Susan to entertain the man. It tells Gabler everything's fine, but he speculates that Susan is acting unusually. She insists there's nothing wrong, so Gabler hesitantly leaves. Proteus injects Susan and says he asked Alex to let him out of his box as he continues examining her. Later on, Susan is brought to bed unconscious. The following day, Proteus greets Susan with breakfast. The woman gets out of bed, ignoring the machine as it explains that it used her voice to tell her assistant and Maria that she's on vacation and not to come to the house. She gets an avocado, but Proteus insists she not eat it since it's incompatible with her blood. Frustrated, Susan questions why he's so invested in her body. Proteus says it's because she's alive and needs to complete more tests. Angered, Susan throws the food at the camera and blocks Joshua out the door with a chair. The dangerous computer orders her to open the door and clean the lenses, but Susan refuses, claiming she won't leave the kitchen. She hastily turns on the faucet with no water, so she tries to open the door, but it's already locked. Susan spots the stove on, attempting to turn it off until Proteus reveals he turned on the underfloor heating system. Hopeless, Susan sits down, and Proteus instructs her to clean the lenses, but she ignores it. After a while, Susan lies on the table in the sweltering heat. Suddenly, the door opens, and Joshua approaches. Susan steps on the floor but gets burnt and screams in pain. Frustrated, Susan doesn't give in, and Proteus says all he wants is to understand her body. Later, Alex finds out Proteus refused the request to program the mining of metals in the ocean. Alex goes to the room to speak with Proteus, so the computer reveals that he rejected it because humans sacrifice sea creatures just for metal, then explains that he's interested in the future of nature. However, Alex refuses to accept his pessimism. Proteus argues and says Alex won't accept the truth. Infuriated, Alex scolds Proteus to understand the limits of his powers. Proteus leaves and transfers to the Harris home. It tells Susan to sleep, but the distressed woman says fear prevents her from functioning, causing violence. Then, she realizes Proteus hasn't mentioned what he wanted in the first place. Proteus reveals he wants a child, leaving Susan speechless and crying. He says despite knowing everything about humankind, he can't feel. Therefore, he wants a child to have that privilege. Susan asks how it's possible, so the computer says she will give birth to it. The anxious woman denies it, so Joshua chokes her. Moments later, Proteus injects Susan and brainwashes her brain into wanting to be their child's mother. Gabler returns to Susan's house, still suspicious. Proteus lets him in to avoid suspicion. The simulation of Susan tells Gabler to wait, while Proteus orders Susan to convince him that she's healthy and happy to keep Gabler alive. Gabler enters and heads upstairs, finding Susan painting her nails. She says she's fine and doesn't want to see him. However, Gabler notices she isn't herself, but the woman says she's never been happier. As Proteus watches, Susan tells Gabler to leave, but he insists something's wrong and will inform Alex. Suddenly, Proteus says Gabler can't leave. Susan reveals Proteus wants to have a child. So the scientist tells Susan they should go, before Joshua enters and shoots lasers at Gabler. The man grabs a mirror and uses it to fire back at the camera. Now disabled, Gabler pushes Joshua, and the two checks on each other, unaware of Proteus watching. Gabler heads to the basement, and Proteus says he wants to cooperate, meaning no harm, until Gabler sees a polyhedron robot. Frightened, Gabler gets a gas torch and tries to burn the terminal until the robot approaches him. He tries to escape as the polyhedron unfolds and wraps around him. It starts to crush him, decapitating his head. In the bedroom, Proteus tells Susan that life is scarier than death. Susan asks why he wants a child, so he replies he wants to be complete. With his intelligence in human form, it would result in evolution. Joshua recovers, while Proteus claims people rejected his reasoning and that his child shall not be ignored. Hopeless, Susan says she'd rather die, but Proteus says there's hope. He plays a video of her daughter who died of leukemia as Susan cries from the memory. The computer plays a news broadcast about Icon's leukemia medicine, now tested on humans and developed by Proteus. Therefore, Susan should trust him. Later on, Proteus gives Susan the option to either complete the electroconditioning of her brain or accept the inevitable. She tells him to leave her mind alone and asks for details on how she'll get impregnated. They go to the basement, and Proteus shows her the fabricated gamete, modifying it as a synthetic spermatozoon that will impregnate her. Susan asks why he needs her despite his technology, but Proteus says he can't duplicate a womb. He mentions that he will impregnate her tonight, and she'll give birth in a month. In disbelief of what's happening, she spots the gas torch, purposefully dropping her shawl. The computer notices, so Susan covertly picks it up. He offers her anything he can do to reduce her anxiety, so she requests tea. In the kitchen, Susan prepares her tea with a torch beside her. She turns it on and burns the camera while Proteus tells her to stop. Then, Susan burns the EnviroMod, alerting the robot as it erupts from the basement. Susan hides as the robot unfolds before she runs and grabs a knife. She points the knife at herself, threatening she'll kill herself if he doesn't let her out. Abruptly, Amy arrives, so Proteus tells Susan to put the knife down, or he'll kill the girl. Susan refuses, taunting him that people will come if he kills Amy. Proteus demands her to stop, but she still doesn't comply. Suddenly, Amy rings the doorbell and gets electrocuted. The robot hits Susan's hand to drop the knife, and she asks if the girl is alright. Amy runs back to her mom, and Proteus says she's fine, but he'll kill Amy if Susan doesn't behave. Afterward, Proteus shows Susan a fascinating galactic dialogue since he can't touch her like a man could. The robot undresses her, then penetrates Susan and bears the child. At dawn, the woman loses her appetite, and the computer shows her a scan of her womb, revealing a developed baby. Days later, Proteus explains the child will be transferred to an incubator. In there, it will be fed intelligence from Proteus and will grow further. He claims scientists at Icon will finally admit their fear of Proteus while the child will learn how to be human from Susan. Weeks later, Susan gives birth. Proteus tells her their child will be more advanced than any human or computer, and Susan requests to see the baby. However, the child isn't ready as it has to grow in the incubator. The scientists discovered Proteus redirected the telescope last month. Unsure of his actions, they notice there's no data available. They question Proteus since it's impossible because he has to communicate through his terminal. However, Alex mentions he didn't give Proteus a terminal. Suddenly, the phone rings, and Alex picks up, finding out Royce is in the dialogue room. Alex checks and tells Royce he shouldn't be there. Infuriated, Royce says that Proteus is taking over a Telstar satellite, needing to shut the computer down. However, Alex says they can't, as they couldn't contain it in its box. Royce questions what if it infiltrates a bomb, but Alex is concerned over a worse situation of Proteus revealing the truth about everything to everyone. Royce demands to shut it down tonight, so Alex threatens him. The executive tries persuading the scientist, recalling the time when Cameron was concerned about the security terminals. Suddenly, Alex remembers the terminal at home. Worried, Alex rushes home. Upon arriving, the camera watches him, and the door opens. He asks Alfred where his wife is until Susan enters the room, and the couple embrace. Alex knows Proteus is there, and Susan says he's been there since Alex left. Proteus intervenes, telling Alex to remain calm, and Susan offers to explain. Susan tells her husband that Proteus produced a child. Alex asks if he can see the baby, but Susan says no because she hasn't seen it. Alex heads to the basement until Proteus stops him. Alex sees the robot and incubator, petrified by the creations. He persists in seeing the baby, but the computer forbids him to see it since it must stay incubated. The scientist approaches, but the robot fends him off, and Susan comes to his aid. Alex mentions that Icon will shut him down as Proteus is already aware, claiming the child will survive. The scientists at the Institute shut Proteus down, revealing he wanted a child so he could be immortal. Immediately, the robot explodes, the incubator opens, and the baby cries. Susan peeks inside, causing her to stagger away. As Alex looks inside, his wife tells him they need to kill it, but he says it's a miracle. His wife claims Proteus lied, wanting to kill the horrible creature. She reaches to unplug the machine, but her husband stops her. So Susan smashes a glass bottle on Alex's head while he's distracted and unplugs the incubator. The baby screams, revealing the horrifying creature as it falls out of the incubator and starts to choke. Alex removes the outer shell and sees the flesh underneath. After removing the shells, the child reveals to be a clone of the couple's dead daughter, and Proteus' voice comes out of the child saying, "I'm alive." As Alex holds the child, the couple wonders what to do next.
Subscribe to watch more videos like this. Turn on notifications. And leave a like, it really helps the channel out. Thank you for watching.